Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Kavinsky's Tutorials. Today I want to look at this new kinky, actually pronounced kinky, I think it's a pun on kinky, by Caelum. So you can download this for free for desktop and Windows on their website, Caelum. They've also got some offers there at the moment, and you can get it for iPad and iPhone on the App Store. And although it's sample based, it's not very big. It's about 12 megabytes to download. And then when you open the app, it'll ask you to download the samples. And I think they're only about 20 megabytes or something. It's not a lot. Sorry. Yeah. No, 20 megabytes. Yeah. So it's really not a lot. Now, it seems very simple. But actually, when I looked at this part, like if you press this randomizer, so here we have this typewriter sound, and you can press this randomizer button, and you'll suddenly see all this coming alive. So what's happening here is that these are being modulated in different ways. The filter resonance and cutoff, sample rate, bit depth, drive and drive offset. I'm not really sure what is being offset with that drive, and I'm not actually hearing any difference with that being tweaked. If I get a message from Caelum telling me what that is, I'll write it in the pinned comment under this video. Reverb, mix and size. And then here we can also assign aftertouch, mod wheel, key tracking and velocity as modulation sources. We have two envelopes, so we can switch between these here with this A and B. So here, for example, we're seeing envelope A's ADSR. And here we're seeing the rate and shape for LFOA. And then if I switch over here, now we're seeing envelope B's ADSR and the rate and shape for LFOB. We also have sync here or free mode for the LFO. So the envelope A will be the main envelope for the synth sounds or the samples. It can also be a modulation source. And then envelope B, that will just be a modulation source. We'll look at that a little bit later. So let me just go back to the init preset here. So we'll just quickly look at the sounds, but I mean, since this is a free app, I really won't spend much time on that. So we have this typewriter and computer keyboard, and then a MIDI keyboard. And then we have a bunch of drum kits of some kind. And here we have this typewriter bells thing. I'm not sure how this has been processed. So there's no manual for this, and there's really very little information about it. Typewriter buzz. So, like, even just the typewriter, some of those sounds are pretty experimental. I don't know what is that doing with the typewriter? No idea. Down here in these lower octaves, we have these more typical typewriter sounds. So, yeah, I mean, we can obviously just tweak these things directly, right? And, you know, dial in exactly what we want. So, you know, just tweak things like that. Or you can assign different modulation sources to control these. So let's look at how you do that. Now, like I said, there is a randomizer, okay? So you can do that. Be very careful. If you start getting into using this randomizer, things can get really loud. And I am using a limiter here after this, and I would strongly recommend that you do the same. So let's say, for example, I wanted to get LFOA to modulate the resonance. So the way this works is you grab this and drag it over here, and then dial in an amount. And you choose the polarity. Will it increase the value or will it decrease it? Okay. Take it to the left to decrease, take it to the right to increase. Okay, so then you can see that here. Let's see, just let's assign the same envelope to cutoff, sorry, the same LFO to cutoff, and let's just modulate it in the other direction. Okay, so, you know, then you can get some pretty wacky stuff, yeah? So let me see here in the preset menu. I saved this one, Ghostly Bells. So, like here we have the envelope set up to modulate the cutoff downwards. And so then we can, you know, change the attack speed and so on down here with the ADSR. And so it would be the same principle with aftertouch, the mod wheel and so on. Okay, if you wanted to modulate this with aftertouch, or let's say you wanted to modulate the sample rate, then you would bring that over, dial in which direction you want it to be modulated and by what amount. And then if your keyboard has aftertouch, you could use that. So I don't have aftertouch here, so I can't really demonstrate that for you. Yeah, so here again, same thing. If you wanted to use mod wheel, just drag that. You know, you want to use mod wheel to modulate the drive, just drag that on and put in your value, right? As I said, you can have the LFO synced or free. One weird little thing is that on sync, when the rate knob is all the way to the left, it is actually the fastest speed. You can see the rate here, 30 second triplet. And then we drag that all the way to the right, that's 32 bars, so that's the slowest. But if I change it to free by just depressing sync here, you can see that now it's the opposite. Now the right side is slow, and the right side is fast, and the left side is slow. So that's something, maybe they will fix that in an update, because that doesn't really seem like it should act that way to me. So there are, you know, a bunch of presets in here as well. But again, you know, since it's a free app, I'll let you really check those out yourself. There are a couple of cool ones in here. Let's just quickly get some examples of them. This can really sound pretty meaty. So here, you know, we've got the bit depth really down. We could just bring that up a little bit. That's kind of cool. You see here reverb mix being modulated. Of course, if you don't like the reverb, just put on your own. And you could get pretty ambient with that. Take that reverb off. Sweat pluck one is pretty cool. So, just a quick little go with the randomizer. So as you'll see, the randomizer only randomizes the modulation section. It won't actually change the instrument type that is selected here. But, you know, it can be interesting to, even with the main presets, like let's just take, say, this QWERTY riser one. So you see this is set up to have the computer keyboard samples. So you can just load up a preset and then change the sample source. So So yeah, really cool for a free app. Okay, we have this modulation view here as well. That just shows you that a bit bigger. Nice. Here, some preset organization stuff, create folders and import stuff. Don't see any batch export or anything here. You know, if you save a preset and you want to delete it, do it here. Save preset here, randomize here. It's all pretty obvious. So yeah, fair play to Caelum Audio for bringing this out for free. Initially, I just thought it would really just be some samples basically wrapped in a, you know, plugin. But I was really surprised to see the modulation system, but also a little bit surprised to see that they didn't just have a paragraph on the website actually explaining how to set up the modulation. So anyway, I hope that was useful for you. If it was, consider smashing the like, writing a comment. If you're into modulation, by the way, I did a video last week on envelope followers that you might enjoy. And like I said earlier in the video, I've also done videos on other apps by Caelum Audio. If you just go into YouTube and search Gavinsky Caelum Audio, you'll find them. Okay, thanks everyone. I'll see you in the next video.